Hearty welcome to the Tema Stadium, and where we have Inter Allies playing against Accra Hartlepool. It's a Premier League game that, of course, is seen as the top liner for this weekend. The Fulvians have had a flamboyant start to the Premier League campaign, and they've had to play some incredible games and getting some victories that is making them become one of the exciting clubs in the country at the moment. After a lot of turbulent times last season, Hartlepool will come out of the tunnel very much confident and hoping at least they can get the needed points against Inter Allies, who themselves have not enjoyed a great start to the Premier League season. So it's a matter of both sides coming in to show what they can give their fans. For the Hartlepool fans who have thronged here to witness this game, all they look out for is a massive win and consolidate their position on the Premier League table. After just 5 matches, this team is looking very much spirited up, and they think that this is the time for them to show what they can actually give out. It's pretty much interesting once again having to see Coach Herbert Tado moving straight to the camp of Inter Allies after leaving Hartlepool, and Ruben Jan, a very tiring defender for the Fulvians. He is so confident, and these fans can afford to encourage the team, pep them up, sing for them, and show their love. It's Cosmos Dowder's day to also show what he's noted for by way of planting the ball at the back of the net. So experience will come to play. 33-year-old Mustafa Suman is going to play a key role for Accra Hartlepool this afternoon. And Isaac Mesa, the young, enterprising left-footed player, also comes in with his own skill. So welcome, Ghanaians, and of course welcome Africa to yet another wonderful game, week 5 of the Ghana Premier League.
Yes, we expect an Inter Allies, you know, to just get out of their shells. It's been a slow start for them, unlike last season where they started brightly. You know, they've lost some key players, and Hartlepool just in fine form and in top shape. Everybody talking about their endurance and energy level. And today, it's another test against Inter Allies, you know, who've got, you know, a better record against Hartlepool, you know, than any of the promoter sites in recent times.
So looking at the setup of Inter Allies this afternoon, Paul Abaka, well, actually started the first game against Nia Dibiase, where they drew, and Haruna Seydou is not starting. It is Frederick Boateng who comes in for him, and so two changes for Inter Allies, going with a 4-1-4-1 formation.
Yeah, the middle is packed there with Mensah, and then Ahoto, Evans Mensah playing against Gokel Ahoto, who's got a better record against Hartlepool, scoring a record, and then Isaac Trum will be operating from the left, and then Boateng in there as well. That's how they want to line up.
So they're going for these formalities for this game to start today, and it is Simon Marty, brother of Adriana Star, Noah Marty, and Daniel Lai is the man to lead the affairs. Philip Doku, Abu Williams, and Abramani Mohammed are the officials for today's game. Ruben Jan was presented with an award by the Fulvians of Crown Hartlepool for his excelling performance for the club as well. And for the Fulvians, they make just one change. Richard Akrofi is not starting, and Vincent Atinga is playing because he picked up the knock in their match against Bechem United.
We understand he was hamstrung and had to be substituted in the 3-1 win over Bechem United. And in his place, we've got Atinga, who joined them 2 seasons ago from Mebusuan Dwarfs, get to start. Ruben Jan will be captain there, and then, you know, the middle is where it will be very, very tight with Saban Lai and Mustafa Esuman. Isaac Mensah operating from the right. And then the forward line is Cosmos Dauda and Sam Yeboa with his experience.
Now Coach Herbert Tado, former Hartlepool coach and a world-traveled coach. Probably would have to call him that. Did the magic with the Jena Stars as well. And Mami Ba will be the man to help his side up today. And Kenechi has come in to transform Hartlepool into a winsome side.
Yeah, he's done a lot of work with his team and still remaining grounded, not getting carried away by their early form, and counting on his key men, especially Ruben Jan, the captain. He's the stalwart at the back there. Likewise, the experience of Mustafa Esuman and goalkeeper Abdullahi Sulama. There's the new chap, the pin-up star for Hartlepool now, Cosmos Dauda. He scored a goal. No, very, very quick, strong, and also good with his finishing as well. And there's a man who's won 2 Man of the Match awards, Evans Mensah. you know, trained from the Right to Dream Academy. And so you can understand his technique and qualities.
Well, that's a hook. We're looking up to this man, Daniel Ayuju, start the affairs here at the Tema Stadium. And so we obviously are in for a very bright game, perhaps, with a bright sun up for this AstroTurf to give us football that all of us have been yearning for. But how great a season perhaps has started for some of the clubs, and especially when they begin their campaign. Then it's hard to get things underway here, and the fans can afford to cheer them up. And all they care about is making sure at least they punish Inter Allies, who themselves have had some great time playing at the Tema Stadium. And that's a foot. Obviously, would have to find themselves just at the edge of the Tema Inter Allies 18-yard box, and would have an injury scare moment there for one of their stars, who is doing a great job for the Fabians as well.
You know, it looks like it was Dada who was trying to weave his way into the box. Yes, it was Dauda, and then what was tripped in the process, I don't think it was anything. And then Isaac Mensah went down, and he remained on the turf. That was unintentional. I think it was a knock, you know, on his head. You know, Dauda, any catches there from the right? It looks like it will be a busy one for Inter Allies, you know, in the center, you know, backs off to the club.
Schumann. Oh, cleared away. Gokila Hocho will be the man to watch for Inter Allies as he tried to find support down the outside side, and maybe appears just to a father's man there.
A bit of a quality move there. You can see he was caught late. Appear with a tackle, trying to stop Frederick Boateng. And I love the role now, how he's been assigned. Not leading the attack like we saw him for Ebusuan Dwarfs some 3 seasons ago. This time around, he's operating as the right winger in the absence of Lord Opuseni, who is serving a four-match ban. He got sent off here when they played against Dreams FC in the 2-2 draw. And this will be the second start for Boateng this season.
Well, a lot of the players are being treated pretty much early since the game started. Frederick Boateng doing his job there as a right winger. While the Inter Allies have engaged hard to poke in for since they came to the Premier League in 2013. They've just had a wonderful win for them, and of course now the folk have won twice here. And so looking ahead to seeing what they can produce in Talas, can they really dwell on Gokela Otto, with these fans also hoping at least Hartlepool will pick up a win.
Now this is just a huge turnout we have here. You can see very, very packed, and the fans coming in their numbers. Good for Hartlepool. They're trying to also, you know, help other clubs make some money, raking some money as well.
Take advantage of the times, and have a free kick now to defend the Fabians. Evans Mensah, Simon Marty there. It's Evans Mensah balling for one, and well played away by Isaac Mensah.
I think they'll be missing the services of Nyari Benogo. He played for them last season. He signed, you know, for a Slovenian club, one of the many players who left Inter Allies at the end of the season. And some of them even went midway, you know, to clubs in Scandinavia.
And the likes of Baba Mensah, one of them trying to move out.
Now I love the build-up. You know, a bit slow from Inter Allies, trying to see if they can play a bit of dizzying football. But then Hartlepool will be tough.
Boy, it's Evans Mensah just cutting in so well, and gets the first corner kick. And Inter Allies doing it slowly, but at least they're getting there.
You can see that Robin Yan was caught out of place there. Two players went past him. Evans Mensah racing for the ball, but a sliding tackle from Atinga.
Another corner kick now for at least Inter Allies, who are beginning to put a lot of pressure on a pretty hard to fuck in this early moment. It's an early goal which actually unsettled the Fabians, but it remains to be seen if that obviously is going to be sustained. Mensah again, trying to cut in. Well, it's been blocked again. Inter Allies struggling to break out the hook. Oh, how many legs were there to block those shots?
You know, how did they miss that? You know, early warning shot fired. Nice move there, and it was from their Nigerian import, you know, who tried to get it. This was Evans Mensah with the attempt, and it was redirected and Hazepok under pressure at this point in time. Nice corner kick taken there from Evans Mensah. And they all flag their lines just in front of goal.
Talais beginning to push moment forward. Now to fall backtracking at the moment to defend their lines. There's Ropapa on the ball. Traps it backwards again. And Talais. It's painting hard to focus to their own half. And they get a free kick again.
I must say, credit to Inter Allies. I've not been impressed with their performance so far. Remember, after winning against Eduana Stars, they lost at Liberty Professionals. Then they drew 2-2 here with Dreams FC, went away last week, and also earned a point against New Edibiasu United. We thought, you know, their form has dipped a little bit, but this is an improved display in the opening minutes. With the ball being pinged around, a bit of quality and know-how with Panache. They're trying to see if they can knock Hazepok off.
Take a short free kick again. Hazepok went out to regroup again, and they have scared the ball out of the danger zone. Oh, Kennedy Appiah seems to have picked up a knock. Maybe he may not be able to continue with play. Just about 6 minutes, and he's really, really in pain.
That's, I think, a relapse of that injury he suffered, you know, early on when he went in for a tackle, his thigh. If it's a muscle, you know, a problem, then I think it will be difficult for him to continue. He's been, you know, the established, you know, left back, joined the club on transfer deadline day from Ashanti Gold, and he's been such a revelation at Hazepok.
Well, that will be a huge disappointment if he's unable to continue. But of course, Evans Mensah here.
Well, that was the first tackle, I think, early on. You saw him. And then I think that and it looks like Evans Mensah can't continue because I can see the Hazepok bench trying to get a player ready to come on. It might be Fatal Mohamed.
Square playing, and Inter Allies would have the opportunity here to go. Oh, that's a poor ball there. And I was just wondering what Isaac Chung was doing when he had a chance.
It's unbelievable, but you know, miscommunication between Isaac Chung and Frederick Boateng. Nice pass there, just keeping the defenders out of the equation, the Hazepok defenders. And Boateng was waiting for an assist. And how did the Hazepok defense, you know, got carved open on that occasion? A bit of a shock defending.
Well, the injury to Kennedy Appiah meant that at least there was a little of a gaping hope there, so they had to exploit that, and that's how come the ball sent to nobody was there to defend. But Ibrahim there.
They're going in strongly. The left back for today. Inter Allies started the season with Abbas Mohamed as left back. And the youngster seems to have lost his position. And as a substitution, Fatal Mohamed is coming on. Such an injury blow early there for Hazepok. One of their best performance for the season.
Huge disappointment. And Hazepok now doing what you noted, and they have a free kick just in front of the 18-yard box now, and they obviously would have Eric Kumi doing what they expect him to do.
You know, just getting himself into the game, warming up. Nice play there from the left, and then he was caught late. Simon went on, and from Boateng tracking back, a bit of a problem there. And it was Ahoto Gokel, you know, with that tackle late one. He did good call there from Daniel Lai.
Zuri Kumi scored against Mijema. He's always playing as the right winger and sometimes cutting into the man up there. And Ushibempa will try his luck from this one. And Suman, and again it's been blocked, and the Talais will have Ropapa also leading the attack and make sure the attacker crowd out to book. And it's been one of a game that you expect a lot of physicality. Prince Bafo also doing his job there, trying to shepherd the ball out, and because Inter Allies will definitely have themselves to look up to in terms of this game. A lot of pressure on them as well. Last season it wasn't the same, and this season it appears different.
Yeah, I think there's a new team getting young boys, and it will take some time for them to blend. Oh, that was a bit too reckless there from the part of Robin Yan. You know, went in to push his man off the ball. I don't like the setup of Pass of Hook defense today. They've been caught off guard on a few occasions.
Well, the injury to Richard Akufi means that an unlikely partnership, Atenga and Ruben Yan. So I think Ruben Yan will probably be doing a lot of overtime when the balls are sent into the box there.
Exactly.
Well, opening 10 minutes, I've seen plenty of the balls going to Inter Allies. We're still trying to find some space. A lot of times they have had the opportunity to do so. Squatting. And
it was a bit slow there, and you can see Bempa covering up. Bempa, I think, has been moved to the left back row there, and Fatal Mohamed was slotting us right back. He came on for the injured Kennedy Appiah.
And a bit of a huge run there, and that's the strength Hearts of Oak would have. And that's supposed to be a free kick. Was there a deliberate push there?
No, it was. And Wahab Akwey will be talked to. This is what Colin Cosmos Dada, you know, brings to the team. His speed and strength and also skills, making it difficult for, you know, defenders to keep track on him. A bit needless from Wahab Akwey, but what do you expect? He had been lost there in the process. Dada did well to get past his man easily.
Well, playing against Hearts of Oak, he probably would have to make sure you keep the balls out of the 18-yard box with set pieces. Owusu Bempa lifted up and well punched away by goalkeeper Kwame Ba.
Now Kwame Ba getting to Stratton staff in the absence of captain of the side, Osei Kwame. And Kwame Osei, this was a good one there. With ease, he fired it over, you know, for a corner kick. But Hearts of Oak now bounce it back after Inter Allies dominated for some few minutes. They've also mounted attacks, and they've been exhilarating to watch sometimes when they go on around.
Vicious effort there from Hearts of Oak, and Eric Kumi was also trying his luck there. Searing shot, maybe trying to tease goalkeeper Kwame Ba.
He could have done better. That was a corner kick and headed out. Nobody contesting for that ball. You can see he had a lot of room, you know, to operate, but Kumi's skied efforts just can't get the opening goal here.
Well, ahead of this game, Gokala Hodge said he was really going to do what he did to Hearts of Oak. Season's back.
Well, he's got back-to-back in back-to-back games against Hearts of Oak. And last year, we were here when he scored at the death of that game to give Inter Allies a 2-1 win. That was a belter.
Very much.
Beautiful goal he scored.
There's some bit of a scrappy defensive play from Inter Allies, especially when they are on the attack. Just having to get the ball out of their danger zone. On to the ball on the turf and spring it up. Now you have the likes of Ivan Smeisa. He'll shift it to the left hand side. A very fast player. It's Fatal who needs to come clean and stop him. Mr. Fusman is also out there. It's been Inter Allies trying to press and keep possession.
Well, lovely from them. Trying to zip the ball around, waiting for that opening.
And they get a free kick for that.
You know, good free kick and by Chum. Oh, it was taken quickly, but then this one tried to be smart, but
well,
then
just saluting the referee. He's knowing, he knows he's actually committed a crime there.
Being talked to, and this was internalized with Isaac Chum with his kill, and that's obviously a free kick. Someone lie with a boot, you know, on Isaac Chum. know, I love the way they've stayed focused, Inter Allies. They're not panicking at all, playing according to their own rhythm.
Well, they can't have the opportunity to score. And what a block there from Ruben Yan.
You know, good defending there. And once again, where was the defending? It's still not, you know, the sort of watertight defense we saw Hearts of Oak against Medeama and also against Bechem this season.
It's still in town. Lice Ibrahim with the ball. What is that foot? And again, that is not a very serious one there. But of course, we've seen in town Lice a couple of times just moving into empty spaces just in the 18 yard box of Hearts of Oak.
Now, this was a free kick. Well lobbed, dinked forward. And Buffalo was left all alone. Nobody was closing him down, but it was a quick one there. Fast intervention coming in from the captain, Yan.
Lots of folks seem to be playing with heavy feet. You're wondering what the reasons may be. That's a very unusual way of defending, Namdi.
That was the Nigerian input, Kingsley Namdi. And he's the first player to pick up in a booking here.
First, Lukac going to Inter Allies defender. Foot high challenge. Now, this could actually cause stability at the back. And they still have the opportunity to defend this free kick. A lot of the free kicks have actually been conceded right in front of the 18-yard box, and this is one of them. Goes to Hearts of Oak. Resenting and blocked again. Spencer.
And that was a late charge. Caught him very, very late, Evan Spencer. And you can see Itala is very, very quick in getting the ball out of their danger area. Yeah, but it was a sliding, a good sliding one, you know, from Isaac Mensah. And I love him tracking back and assisting his men in defending.
Well, 9 goals have been scored in the 4 fixtures, both sides have played. Hearts of Oak scoring 5, Inter Allies scoring 4.
And so the, you know, one time that Inter Allies have been able to win against Hearts of Oak, and that was the 2-1 win here last season.
Well, it's not really living up to the billing after just 18 minutes of play, maybe expecting a fast-paced game, but it appears both sides are taking it cool and keeping it calm.
I think I love the quality also from both sides.
Well, there's a lot at stake for Hearts of Oak, especially when you look at the performance on the Premier League table, and they not really want to leave anything for chance when WOW Stars are just on their heels, and they want to make sure at least a 3-point becomes theirs. But Ivan Benz are trying to find support. Slow Papa.
Ivan Benz has been given a lot of room to operate this afternoon by Hearts of Oak.
Kumi, who's the first Schumann.
No, good recovery there from Inter Allies and how they win the ball, but this one has been jaded in the middle. Hot Gokil.
But Namdi would have to come pretty strong on Samuel Boa. Isaac Mensah. The Schumann again. Of course, now they obviously want to use his feet. Takes this ball up. And the Schumann flagged offside. Chest in the box there.
You know, good play there from Hearts of Oak. And you can see the ball was retained, you know, for some time. And Abu Williams. And this was it. Oh, that was served. Very debatable, questionable, dodgy officiating there.
Samuel Bois. So it's coming on to playing for Hearts of Oak. He's actually scored some incredible goals for them as well.
No, he scored 2 so far. in the opening 1-0 win over ABC was there. And there's Frederick Boateng with Owusu Bempa. A bit of force there from Owusu Bempa, and it went into Ally's way.
We're trying to make sure at least they've had some space, and it's been difficult for both sides as well.
So far, nobody has been able to take the commanding charge of the game. Occasionally, it's been swinging. That was aggressive. The referee allows play to continue.
Thank you very much from both sides. Trent Barthel. Couldn't get a commanding start in Kumasi Asante Kotoko. And once again, Eshiman doing his job. And Isaac Mensah picking things up in midfield. And Atafo deciding to break Fatal Mohamed. Isaac Mensah looking for space. The ball 15 and cleared out. And again, Mensah. And there'll be a lot of talking points as to how Atafoke are really getting themselves in there and trying to tease up Kwamiba.
You know, good one there from Mensah. Set up neatly and then the cross. This was, it wasn't dealt with properly. But then the return from Mensah, it was wide. But good attempt there from Atafoke. And this man, the last game they played, you know, he was MVP.
Again, Intalais struggling to keep possession up. Ropapa does a good job there, and can Freddie Boateng get to it? Oh no, just couldn't.
Boateng is not a speedster, you know, he's the man leading the attack, and Ebetado wants to improvise and bring him to the right. You can see he lacks the speed.
You're talking about Gokul Houghton, how he's not really been able to stamp his authority in the game. He's been sandwiched, he's been taken out.
No, not really, but then his controls are letting him down in the middle.
He need to be a bit about him. Isaac Chung basically is dropping deep to help.
You know, for me, I thought Evans Mensah and Cole with their skills, he was going to complement his effort there, but then hey, in the absence of Nete, he gets to start, and he's not being exciting for me.
Well, how much of a room is Robert going to get? His control is Boateng. And Boateng gets clearance for Hartefolk.
So we saw Hartefolk being backpedaling for the greater part of the game against Medeama, and then went on to win 2-0. So you shouldn't be surprised if they are being pinned down. So far as they don't concede, you know, they're as good as, you know, scoring also.
In the 2013-2014 season, Hartlepool won back-to-back against Interlaced. 3-2 here and 1-0 at the Accra Sports Stadium. Now the following season, it was a different story.
That's when they won by 2-1 here. And that was an improved Interlaced, you know, setup.
Still trying to fight Hartlepool yet to concede an away goal so far in the Premier League. The only goal they conceded was in a home game against Bechem United. So Owusu Bempa. Still Hartlepool. And his effort, obviously, is so feeble to Kwamiba.
Definitely, you can't be the Ghana under 20 goalkeeper. And this week, had to join his, you know, colleagues in camp. And their head coach is seated, you know, in the VIP stand.
Really not mean much of a game where you see lots of passing games coming in or passing balls, and a few times when they do, it just lasts for some few seconds or minutes and it's lost again and just beginning to balloon the ball up.
Well, this is a tight game, Benjamin. You can see
it's really a tactical game for both sides. Very tactical.
For Hasselhoff, you know, they just don't want to be surprised by any team. So still remaining cautious. You know, it's early days, you know, in the season, and we'd like to remain a bit compact.
Very quick for Hartlepool. Oshibempa waiting for it. Oh, it's not been moved to left hand side here. And Small Martin as well to win back possession for Inter Allies, the captain.
He's the third captain in the absence of Nete. And also, Kwame Bynes is the captain. This was a tackle from Simon Marty, and it came off Dauda. A good call there from the ref. Kumi was caught late. And there was a 40 pass there from Frederick Boateng, and he went to commit that free kick. And for me, two players in the entire line setup, I'm not really gelled. Frederick Boateng and then Ahoto Gokel. And you can see the experience of Mustafa Isuman and Saban Nai making it difficult for Gokel in the middle.
Oshibempa and Isuman. Danilai beginning to have some harsh words there with Freddie Boateng and Simon Mate for overstepping your lines. Well, that's Hartlepool free kick to be defended. Taken, and again it's been cleared out by Namdi. And it's still beginning to show that both sides are not ready to give up. No, both sides are not ready to open up so far. So tactically, a very tight game.
How does it? Italia is, when their defending has been solid. You know, with Simon playing, and then Alhassan Ibrahim, and also the centre back pair have been very glued. I'm talking about Wahab, and then Kingsley Inamti.
Inter Allies have conceded in all home matches in the month of March since they came to the Premier League in 2013. And again, there's another way of losing possession so cheaply. And Harry Kumi would have to make sure at least he turns things up in midfield, trying to look for space. And Hartlepool seem plenty of possession so far. Isaac Chum now.
Oh.
Again, Inter Allies just doing the right thing. And again, doing the wrong thing as well.
Chum won the ball back, turned nicely, but then his pass was poor.
Suman with his experience. Well, apart from Salama and Suman, who are in their late 30s, most of the Hartlepool players are in their mid-20s as well, with Aziz Mesa just one of the youngest in the team.
And also we've got the former Ghana, the 20 captain, the last edition. Oshibempa is in there. There's Fatal Mohamed also playing. It's quite a youngish squad they have. Another 40 pass again from Inter Allies. They're giving away the ball that cheaply under no pressure at all.
Schumann, not far out of hook. Oh, lovely ball here. And Fatal Mohamed, first time control, letting him down and just can't get the ball into the 6 yard for Samuel Bouan. Cosmos down to pounce on it.
This was the run, and the ball dinked up front, neatly there by Schumann. It bounced correctly, but he took his eyes off the ball. You know, what a chance. It would have been something promising for Hartlepool, but Mohamed failed to convert that one. Should have been a straightforward cross inside the box.
Matinga will have to find support at the back. 36-year-old Lama. Be part of the Burkina Faso AFCON team, the qualifiers as well.
After this game, he's supposed to leave, you know, to join his Scallions teammates.
But three Hartlepool players have been called up by the national team coach, Fulvia Guidi, to play for Togo. Rubin Nyan, first time call up to the Ivorian national side, and you do always will have Sulama. A lovely ball sending, and Sulama drops it, and Inter Allies. Oh, well, what a chance again sensational one from Sulama.
You know, the man who has got back-to-back scoring record against Hearts of Oak, Sumala. So Abdullahi Sulama making amends there for his earlier blip. And this was it from Hota Agwakel. And what a save.
That was his trademark shot there to punish Hearts of Oak, and he nearly did.
You know, good drive, but quality save there from the Burkina Faso international.
And Interlice in firm control at the moment, at least first shot at goal. And a save that had to come in there from Sulama.
Well, that was a super save. And he did well to make amends. It was an earlier, you know, error, costly error indeed, spilling the ball.
Lost possession, but again coming back to win it. Well, they are known as the 11-1.
I don't understand that. Is that philosophical?
Well, I was thinking you probably would be able to give an indication to that one. How
it means we are united, right? 11 players playing together, 2-for-1 goal, one objective.
Yes. That'll be a huge disappointment there for Hearts of Oak in terms of their performance this afternoon. They've not been that in terms of their pressing games.
Now this was the drive from Gokil, and what a save from Sulama. You know, gradually they are coming into the picture in Talais.
Mesa again. Isaac Chum to the right hand side. And wasted effort. And how did he drop the ball, Sulama?
A bit surprising there, shocking goalkeeping from the experienced man. But the important thing was that he made amends and then placated the fans.
Well, just as we're talking about the international duties for these Hearts of Oak players, then he was nearly surprised there with that shot there from Ahato. There's a Schumann here. That's Ari Kumi. Again,
lack of communication. He was expecting Simon Mate to go, but I think, you know, Isaac Chum has been sluggish this afternoon. Not the sort of performance we saw him put up, you know, in the 2-0 win over Adriana Stars.
I would have actually loved the service of Lord of Oshihini as well. And they had to play against Jim's FC here. Lord of Oshihini picked up a red card. Since then, he's not been able to play a role for them as well.
He's serving a four-match ban. I think this will be the second game, you know, he will miss. The four-match ban includes the match he got sent off. So he will miss next week's FA Cup game. And he should return for the, you know, action after the international break.
You know, some lousy play there from Interlice, and we'll have to watch the run there with a nice of Cosmos now and Arukumi. When they have possession, sometimes it's a matter of they not knowing how to deal with it, and so they just give it out. And so they have now to make sure they work with the Hearts of Oak. Have lost once in day five away games since 1999, but this is the first time that challenge. Ahoto again controlling affairs in midfield. Simon Mate picking up, more shifted down to the right hand side and looking for space. Isaac Mensah, who has been drifted wide, and Sulama will be always available to help Hearts of Oak. Well, the very first time that Interlice lost at home in the Premier League was back in 15th of September 2013, match day one. As against the Busuan Dwarfs, that game they lost by 2-0. And they've actually been a very improved side, even winning a couple of matches, as well as even getting to the finals of the FA Cup as well, Interlice. The Again, you talk about the defensive organization of Hearts of Oak, and it's really been not improved since Akrofi picked up an injury, and it appears that it seems to be some hole up there between the center back, yes, Atenga and that of Robinyan.
They've not been tight, like we saw in the opening three games, you know, where they played it very, very compact at the back, you know, with Akrofi and then Robinyan, the partnership. You know, it's about why I'm refusing to understand, because Atenga has been at the club for some time now and played with Robinyan before. You know, so that telepathy should be there, and the understanding.
There's one thing keeping possession, and there's one thing doing something meaningful with possession.
And Itala should know that, you know, the more touches you have, the minutes, you know, goes, and they have to make something purposeful. Nice games, threading it to the left this time around.
Yeah, largely they have to lose the possession they have in Talais. Well, Hearts of Oak sitting deep and soaking the pressure, maybe trying to pounce on them with a counter-attacking football, maybe.
Exactly the game plan we saw in Takwa against Medeama, and they ended up winning by 2-0.
Well, they can see the frustrations from Hearts of Oak because the players are now moving into empty spaces for passes.
Credit to Talais, you know, for clamping them down. They are very, very mobile, the Hearts of Oak players. And today, they're not the sort of same team we saw against Medeama and also against Mbeche.
They're just hoping to use the speed of Cosmos Dalda. And they just talked about him, and he gave me the signal that he can actually shoot from afar.
You know, that was a flash attempt. Just wanted to creep one in. It was quite opportunistic, but it didn't come off well on a half volley.
It's Menta and Oshu Bempa trying to cut him to his left. Isaac Chum lifting the ball down to the left-hand side, and Freddie Boateng can't reach that.
Yeah, Freddie Boateng has not performed. I talked about him. That was poor timing. And he's telling, you know, Chum to keep the ball on the turf because he's been blighted by the sun. And there's Isaac Mensah who's on the turf now. I think he's suffered from a stomach problem.
A bit of a knock there from him, one of the exciting players in the Premier League.
This season he showed, you know, maturity and has been consistent. And that's Black Stars assistant coach Maxwell Kunedu and former Cameroon and Borussia Dortmund striker Ibrahim Tanko. And that's the pundit. Coach Ebenezer Sefa.
They look for scouting at home as well.
And also Super Sport Pandit occasionally, you know, joining the team there. I'm trying out to get some anointment with Kenichi and his energetic striker, Dauda Cosmos. Or Cosmos Dauda. The Hearts of Oak fans are in their numbers, but they are not singing. We want them to, you know.
Well, it's a matter of they not really enjoying the game because they expect Hearts of Oak fans to enjoy the football that they saw at the Transport Stadium, the football they saw against Medeama. But that is not really is the case this afternoon. They've actually been pressed deep into their own half and have had a few moments to shoot that goal. And so that becomes a very unfriendly atmosphere for the fans to be singing, especially so when a team isn't pushing.
You know, they have to do something. You know, we saw Kotoko in the rain. You know, just a pocket of supporters. They did very, very well. They sang throughout, you know, the match.
And they got the result they needed.
And they had the one good. Maybe if they start singing, Hearts of Oak will pick up. Because they are dominating here. I don't think it's Ally supporters who count to somewhere 200. It's been all Hearts of Oak.
Watching again, Mensa.
Mensa now switching play and trying to see if he can destroy Hearts of Oak, you know, from their left.
Well, a potential win for Inter Alliance will lift him up from the 10th position. Simon Mate in the box. Oh, that was not supposed to be a pass, that was supposed to be an effort at goal.
I thought it was an effort at goal. but across the face of the goalpost of Sulama. That was a lovely 1-2 play there from Inter Allies. I thought he should have dragged the ball, but cut it back a little bit, not to go in for that shot. But he was losing his footing, and so he decided to put his leg through. Ropapa took his eyes off the ball.
Italians have played as many as 32 home games, lost 6 out of them, and now they have to defend with Hartlepool. Samuel Yabo on possession.
He's been quiet today.
Has been kept out there by Kingsley Namdi and Ohaba Quay. Now they do have possession back out to folk. There's a lot of strength in midfield. And well, it was obviously will be skied up there by Isaac Mensah, who now drifted into the left-hand side after playing some cameo role on the right-hand side as well.
Yeah, lovely, you know, turn there from Hearts of Oak. And there's a second attempt from Isaac Mensah, all going off target. Yeah, but when he controlled on his left foot, it looked promising.
They're still coming in to the first half and catch. With all the possession and with all the controls.
Yeah, handball there from Ropapa. You know, he scored a goal this season. You know, he's promised to do more. He signed a permanent deal. He joined the club from the second tier side in Cape Coast and on loan last season for the second half of the season, and he's been handed a permanent deal.
But the laterals of Inter Allies have actually occasionally moved up to support. We see Momante coming in, and Ibrahim also doing his job on the left hand side as well.
You know, everybody playing his role, you know, in this game.
Skumi coming back to take the ball from his defensive area.
Yeah, but Boateng put his leg through there and he managed to halt Hearts of Oak on the run.
Trying to appeal for a foul there.
Oh, the referee thought he dropped or went down easily.
And that's rather a foul against Inter Allies.
Against it's one a shot.
Rather against it.
You know, but I thought his foot went, you know, up. You know, before it was advantage Inter Allies from Agoko. And then Esuman went in there. So my total of 15 fouls and only one yellow card. Kingsley Namdi is the only player to have been booked.
Fisherman again for Hearts of Oak. And trying to push moment forward and trying to take on the speed. Well, Fosmos Dauda.
No, he's lacked services this afternoon. The balls have not reached him.
They can only have the balls when Eric Kumi and Isaac Mensah are moving into space. Any good players are yet to move into those areas. You expect not to get the supplies coming in. And especially again when you have Isaac Mensah drifting to sometimes defend, it becomes difficult a little bit to move. So far it's been an even encounter from both sides occasionally. Some bit of a attempt at goal coming in, and there's a foul here against Inter Allies left back Alassane Ibrahim.
It was Kumi there with an extension of his arm. The ball bounced, he lost control. The header went in from Kumi, and then you can see, yes, even before he contested for that area ball, he had his arm stretched.
Anytime I think that moves out there, there's some bit of a hold in the defensive area of Hearts of Oak, and so still trying to find some middle for going to hit on that one. Is a miss there from Rubinyan, and it still comes back to Inter Allies, who have possession to still attack across Hearts of Oak.
So far it looks like Inter Allies are slightly on top. You know, they've made more incursions than Hearts of Oak.
Now they have the ball in the box, and again Hosley again Inter Alliance gets it away.
Hooked away by Hearts of Oak. Good defending there, cutting them out. The last 10 minutes, Hearts of Oak still with ball possession, 67, Inter Alliance 33.
A decision displeasing Hearts of Oak fans. Well, they were thinking that Alizio Bauer was illegally brought down by Kingsley Nnamdi.
Look at the tussle once again. Was it a case?
And a minute of additional time during the first half. And Hearts of Oak just allowing the ball out of play. But again, they will have to keep back possession. Last minutes are down well to win back. Searching for Inter Alliance, going around two men, still moving strong. Cutting in, goes down, gets a free kick.
And the fans not happy with that decision from Daniel Lai. You know, by retaliation, it's a bookable offense. He won it from Isaac Mensah. A bit of physical play, and with his left foot, well coached left footed player, Ivan Mensah. And he was impeded. Osube but kept on piling pressure until he failed him. And so that was a good one there from the ref.
And again, a tackle breakdown for Hearts of Oak. Isaac Chum. Additional minute is up. And Daniel Ayi could just end the first half. Yes, he does end it. A bit of uneventful first half from both sides. Not lived up to the expectation, perhaps, but there's another 45 minutes to be played for, and Ropapa has really been a pale shadow of himself, not really threatening Hearts of Oak, but of course, there was a real shot at goal there from Godkele Hotto, and Kenechi Otuhashu and Yao Preko would obviously come back in the second half, maybe rejuvenated, and see if Hearts of Oak can have the opportunity to win here.
A good one there from Sulama, and you can see there's a bit of a conference between Mustafa Suman and Cosmos Dauda. He lacks services, and I think Isuman is trying to explain why the balls never got to him.
Well, there's plenty of talking to do. And so, first up, ends here at the Tema Stadium. Inter Alliance nil, Hearts of Oak nil.
A keenly contested first 45 minutes, characterized by close shaves, have summarized this half. First 45 minutes analysis coming up. We'll be right back. So it's halftime here at the Tema Sports Stadium, and what a game it has been so far. I'm sure the fans have not been disappointed in the least, but they probably would have wanted a goal or two. It's been keenly contested, with Inter Allies probably slightly on top. I do not know what your verdict is, but I'll bring in my pundit here to share his opinion with us. Coach, and welcome to the halftime break. But what has been your assessment of the first 45 minutes so far?
Yeah, I've watched both sides. What they're doing is that they're putting 9 men behind the ball in loss of possession. Hassel Folk are doing the same, and Inter Allies are doing the same. In loss of possession, they put 9 men behind the ball, so it's very difficult to penetrate. What was helping Inter Allies was the transition. They were having quick transitional balls by using vertical passes and horizontal passes. But then House were able to slow them down and get their 9 men behind the ball to stop them from scoring. So that's exactly what's happening. Both sides are trying to stop the other from scoring. Players are shooting from far, and the goalkeepers are doing well, or players miss target. So until one of the side is able to play quick transition, they will be able to get a goal, or maybe use a set piece to get the win.
You made an earlier point about Hearts of Oak in the pre-match discussion that they have been able to organize their defense so well in the previous games that they've played. Do you think that they've really been able to do that well in this game? They've been quite lucky, if you ask me.
That's right. Not really today, because I think they are missing Akrufi, because he's been pairing up with Robin Yan, and today he's not there. Atinga is there, and then they lost Atinga earlier in the game, so they've shifted Owusu Bempa to the left side, and then they brought on Fatao to the right. It's very difficult when you lose two key players in your defense, and that's why Hassel Folk are struggling. It makes going forward a bit difficult, because they lose confidence at the two new players in the setup. So that's what is really worrying Hassel Folk, but they should be able to get over it. If you look at their central pair, the central midfield, Mustafa Isuman and Saban Lai, they're doing what Arsene Wenger used to do those days by moving their central midfielders like that. That's the orthodox 6 and 8. They move like this, and it's really helping them, because Mustafa is able to stay behind and give those hurting passes, the killer passes. But it's just that Cosmos and Sam Yeboah are not having the ability to control their balls well to score. So it's been very difficult for Inter Allies when it comes to the central midfield position to stop Mustafa Isuman. Apart from that, everything is okay.
Fantastic. Well, we are taking a look at some of the attempts by Accra Hearts of Oak. They have tried probably not too many attempts on the day, but and they've not been able to hurt Inter Allies in the process.
That's right, because like I said before the game started, Herbert organizes his defense well. So all that Hearts of Oak are supposed to do is to be shooting from far, and that's no hurting. And that's why you see them shooting, and they really need to use their set pieces very well. If they are able to do that, it will really help them. But apart from that, penetrating through Herbert's setup, defensive setup, is very difficult. Wahab, the central defensive player, is really, really confident. And it's just like the other guy, Kingsley Imandi, also confident. And so Hearts of Oak really have a lot of work to do. They need to work their socks off to get that goal.
Well, Kanichi said it before the match. He said that Hearts of Oak would have to work hard to get even a point here. But Inter Allies also made quite a number of attempts at goal, and Hearts were lucky on a couple of occasions with goalkeeper Sulama coming to their rescue.
That's right. Sulama's save was super fantastic, because the way he was able to fly high to put the ball behind the post was really, really great. He's done well. He gives his boys the confidence to move forward. He's the big man in the goalpost, and that's really good. That's what you need from your goalkeeper. When the situation is very difficult, that's what you expect your goalkeeper to do. Sulama has been good so far, stopping shots, his distribution to the left and right of the pitch, fantastic. I just hope he'll be able to keep it up to the end of 90 minutes. Either than that, it's going to be very difficult for his side.
Well, we'll take a look at some statistics that would summarize this first 45 minutes. And if you missed the first 45 minutes of action, this would help you have a fair idea of what has transpired so far. Well, in terms of goal attempts, there you have it on this your screen. So 6 for Hearts of Oak and 2 for Inter Allies, and 1 shot on target for Inter Allies, and then 2 for Hearts of Oak. But with the look at this, you might think that probably Hearts have the advantage over, or have the edge over Inter Allies, but it didn't really play out that way.
That's right. What they did was to shoot, but Inter Allies are doing more of the possession, horizontal passes, vertical passes to the side of the pitch, creating width and depth. It's fantastic. And what they also do is to use their Ropa Mensah as the key man, the shield. He gets the ball as the main striker, turns and then gives vertical passes to the flanks, and it's really helping them to keep possession of the ball. Hasofoga has got a lot to do. They need to depend on Isaac Mensah and Eric Kumi at the flanks for them to keep possession. Either than that, it's going to be difficult for them because Evans Mensah, the left winger or the right winger of Inter Allies, has been keeping the ball for them.
Well, with these two guys in mind, you probably think that Kanichi might have to improvise by way of reorganizing his defensive cover and improving his player up front. Now, with the substitution, with the players available to him on the bench, do you think that he might have to make any new changes or just have to reorganize his players on the pitch?
Well, for now, you will have to reorganize his players on the pitch. And then maybe because he hasn't got that strong subs that will come onto the pitch. And so you really need to organize them. You really need to be shifting Kumi sometimes with Cosmos, and that's really going to help him. Apart from that, he's got only Musa Ibrahim on the bench. He's another good chap, but he hasn't got that experience and temperament for this game. So I would expect him to improvise and then look at maybe the first 15-20 minutes and think of substitution.
Well, I'm sure that Coach Kanichi has some aces up his sleeve. He hasn't been too flustered by the goings-on in this first half. It's not really been in the favour of Hearts of Oak, but he probably may have a trick or two up his sleeve. But joining me here at pitch side is Coach Maxwell Kunedu, assistant coach of the Ghana Black Stars, and it's refreshing to have him here. We had Coach Avram Grant witnessing the game at Lankly yesterday, and it's quite refreshing to have him here. Coach, welcome to the Tema Sports Stadium.
Thank you very much.
It's great to have you here. We saw Coach Avram Grant observing the game between Eduana and Ashgold yesterday, and you are here today. Now, let me first of all find out from you, what is your mission here? What do you really have on your card?
Yeah, normally we go around to at least monitor all league matches, where we can go. We do our best to go and to make sure that we support both teams to give up their best, because that's why we are here. We want to monitor them, and when they see our presence, they lift up their games. And today is not different. We've seen a lot of skills being displayed here, and we are happy to be here. And we are also happy the attendance is very, 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 very good. I think so.
It would just be right for us to probably talk about the Black Stars now that you are here. How are the preparations going? We've heard of one or two key injuries to the team. Now, what plans in terms of replacements are you making?
Oh, I think we've had messages through their clubs and all that. So the head coach himself is putting in replacements. I know, but let's wait and see. Tomorrow everything will be dealt with, and I think the general public will be made aware.
What idea do you have about our opponents, the Mozambicans? Do you think that present a tall order for us to scale?
Normally, they're a very good team. Most of their players play in Portugal, and one of their key defenders play in China, and they have a couple of good players. But coming here, they need to win at all costs to brighten their chances. By saying that, they are coming to Ghana to face the Black Stars, so we think there will be a kind of layback and hit us on the counter. That is what I think they will do. But we have put in place already a strategy that can unlock the counter-attack system they want to play here. So we just hope that our boys will get themselves together and give up their best on Thursday.
Well, just a quick word probably on this game final before I let you go. Now, with what you've seen so far in the first 45 minutes, what do you project to be the final scoreline or probably the event of play?
I think Inter Allies are possession a bit in their own half for now. But I don't know whether it's a strategy they use here, or I can't really tell. We have to start the second half before we can see or we can say what exactly they can do. I've seen that they are not also shooting in the first half. But the game changing side, I think they will be shooting from afar, because from here, when you shoot, because of the direction of the wing, you get the power right and you can get a goal. So I think in the second half, we'll see more actions. And saying that, Haas is also playing very, very well in defense and in midfield. They just have to sharpen up their finishing touches, and I think we're going to see a very good action in the second half.
Thank you very much, Coach Maxwell Kunedu, and we hope to see a much improved game in the second half, especially more goals. So coming up, second 45 minutes after this break.
much once again. You must welcome back to the Tema Stadium, where it is now time for both clubs to checkmate each other in the last 45 minutes. That will be the magic moment. Anyone can grab the win there, and the fans can afford to jubilate when the time comes. But for now, it's a matter of both sides just looking offensively to their tactical play and what changes they intend to make. But that'll be a huge call there from Kenichi Ichihashi, especially when he has to make other changes when he's already down with the man, because he had to make a false change with Fatah Mohamed coming in for Kennedy Appiah. And Appiah starts Kenichi wants to also throw in another man and maybe making Ibrahim Musa ready to come in. Well, question is who is coming out, and that's another bright view for the enjoyment of the game. And now the singing can be done in the stands as well.
Oh, they've come in their numbers, the Hearts of Oak fans. There's a huge turnout here at the Tema Sports Stadium. And you can see everywhere packed, you know, outside the stadium. That's the main wall. You know, everybody trying to, you know, get to the action. And you can see the paraphernalia of Hearts of Oak
painting the whole place.
Just making it lovely there. You know, colorful scene there. What is this? Wow,
there's a church behind
there. Oh, yeah, there's
behind the wall. So there you have them.
And it's they're watching from the washroom. That's serious, you know.
Well, they really have an enjoyment. They're enjoying the view of the stadium. So Ridwan, they just have to forgive them. Wherever they find themselves, they can actually watch this game.
No, that's what happens if your team informing Hearts of Oak, ensuring that they're bringing everybody on board, and ensuring that, you know, the league becomes exciting. Everybody has talked about attendance this season. I think it can only be better, you know, and improved. You know, Hearts of Oak had a huge turnout there at the Accra Sports Stadium, where they beat Bechem by 3-1. And this match, you know, they'll also be thinking of that game happening at the Wild Park, where Wild Stars are playing against New DBSU United.
A bit of a delay here because waiting for the goalkeeper of Inter Allies to come in to join his teammates. And well, I'm just wondering how that pan out. Well, the goalkeeper delayed game.
Normal
punishment.
Oh no, that's allowed. No, he's coming on. That's the late Kwame Bah. And that's the referee. And the fourth, I think the fourth official was trying to get him, you know, back. Game held up a little bit, but good enough. Inter Allies, you know, just like they do.
So everything is now set now for the second half to begin. And they obviously would have to face the other side to offer some prayers.
And this has been traditional. It's been, you know, like a pretty much routine. And they had to wait for the goalkeeper as well. So when the goalkeeper had delayed, or when the goalkeeper was laying, they waited for him. And you can see the entire Jose Kwame and the rest.
Hearts of Oak would have to make a change now. It's Ibrahim Musa coming in for Cosmos Dauda.
You know, Dauda. Another best of performances from Dauda, and then Ibrahim Musa, you know, joined the club also this season. You know, played, you know, at the GCS tournament. You know, with this huge premium, he's expected to push Inter Allies around.
You know, they're still moving Inter Allies, and now the first challenge halfway there of Hearts of Oak will go in favour of the Rainbow team. Savan Lai being brought down in front of his 18-yard box, and holding his wrist, he probably might have been stepped on, and maybe adding a pain with Ruben Yan with possession for Hearts of Oak.
No, that was a push, and you understand he suffered a bit of a knock.
I tried to find out some of the challenges that comes in, something very cynical, and Musa brought down in his attempt to get the ball from Prince Baffle, and he's a bit shocked with the decision.
Yeah, because he thought he had the ball, he cleared it, and the yellow card is out. There's no way the referee will rescind this decision. if he brings the card out, you just have to keep quiet, hush up, and then pick it up. Second player to be booked.
Two players. Since about a minute start of the second half, and they get booked. Prince Bafo and now Mustafa Suman. And to defend this free kick. And the fans just shouting for a goal to come in from this one. Dinged it over. There's a bit of a header there from Ahota. Boateng.
That was upper body strength there displayed. Quick one from Boateng.
Yes, that's the way they started off in the first half. That's exactly what they're doing in Talais. Keeping possession and trying to run into empty spaces. And
I think Suman has committed a lot of fouls. I was expecting a booking.
There's a Chum. And Mesa with his ball in. And again, that's a very failed attempt at getting the ball up front there for Rupapa.
That was a bit disappointing there from the promising winger. Who was the target man up front? Rupapa. You know, hasn't quite delivered, you know, for me. Maybe services also have luck, but I like the way sometimes he draws the House of Hope defenders out of their area.
Right, just talking about the tactical decisions of Coach Hebertado. Is he that defensive in his approach to games, or he sometimes decides to open up?
No, he's difficult to score, Hebertado, on a good day.
And that's Ibrahim, who is also charged to have actually pushed the Bandai there.
Looks like it was Saban, you know, who was, you know, pushed there. The ball was not in session at all, and that's the final warning on the entire is left back Ibrahim Alhassan.
Too many fouls being committed. Just around the center circle. That's another one. And the fans showing their displeasure there with some of the calls. I think that it's becoming too many of us now.
I think they're rather trying to protest at the Interlais players from getting overly physical.
Yet again, when they have possession, they sometimes look very confused and hard to fuck, trying to get more men forward. And it's been played out. Again, some of the final touches have not been too precise from Hart of Falkent. No, that was as well.
That wasn't a good cross. And the ball will be ruled back.
Well, obviously, it turned out to be a big rivalry between both sides and the Premier League. Be thinking that Vutsa is going to have a good day with Prince Bafo trying to cut in and look for support down the left hand side. Ivan's Mesa not wasting much time and flipping one in.
Oh, brilliant!
What a shock it is! Hearts of Oak have been stunned again by Interlais. Oh, what a ball! And what a goal! Guess what?
And they'll celebrate with their godfather. The old man is being harassed. Sulama Abdullahi Sumaila had no clue as to the geography of that ball. And Interlais have shut the numbers here. Look at the brilliant play, the set piece. Once again, Ivan Spencer playing a role. A long ball, it wasn't dealt with, and they allowed him to sneak in to score. This is incredible. And Hearts of Oak once again are guilty of switching off in defense. And how did they allow him to sneak in from the back like a thief in the night? Oh, brilliant finish from Frederick Boateng.
Well, so he silenced Hearts of Oak, and the Phobians have been shocked. Interlais lead here by a goal to nil.
The
and Hearts of Oak have never found themselves in this situation before. A go down. Let's see how. And we're going to test their level of bounce back ability.
Well, the very first time that Hearts of Oak have conceded in a game in the Premier League this season.
You know, anytime they score first, you know, and they don't they score first before, you know, you strike again. And we saw it against Mitchell. That was their first goal they conceded. And this is the first time they find themselves down in a game.
Second goal Hearts of Oak have conceded in the Premier League. And this time, it is not Hearts of Oak who started it. It is Inter Allies who are starting to get some opening. And Prince Bafo, Prince Bafo comes in! Oh! Wow! Against the crossbar! And oh! What a miss there from Evans Mensah.
You know, Evans Mensah, you know, was too much in a hurry to finish that one off. But sublime run there from Prince Bafo. You know, I thought he should have pulled the trigger. But dragged the ball back, not the best of connections, came off the side post. And Evans Mensah and Isaac Chou, confusion in front there. What a run. Lion-hearted Prince Bafo. And Isaac Chou's connection, poor one. But that was the miscommunication.
Well, Hearts of Oak defense being torn apart by the short runs there of Prince Bafo. And Mustapha Suman trying to make sure at least he can help things up there for the Phobians.
Let's test their character. Let's see their durability. If Hearts of Oak's early form is anything to go by, then I think this is where, you know, the measuring rod would be for us to test their durability. How strong are they? How can they bounce back? Because it's been minutes of madness at the back there, especially when they switched off in defending.
Together. And Inter Allies are a goal to be good, so probably going back to defend. They've had two glorious opportunities. One they converted, this other one they missed.
The Hearts of Oak must come up with something new.
Now they see more of the ball. It's Isaac Mensah. It's the first one again. The Hearts of Oak now playing it slick in front of the goal area of Inter Allies. There's Prince Bafo again. A wonderful play there from the 11-1 side. And again, they give the ball back to the Phobians. It's Isaac Mensah, and he obviously will be fouled.
Simon Marty there with the foul, but has to put quickly a bit of urgency in their play. They want to make amends.
Hearts of Oak had a very wonderful season back in 1999. They had a 3-0 win as an away game against Tanoba Fakwa. And now they can afford to also get some space and maybe trying to work the ball into the net, and has to be stopped. And now Inter Allies will have to make sure at least they still keep pressure on Hearts of Oak. But interesting how the Phobians have actually not been able to exert a lot of influence in this game since they started. A lot of talk about their form and how they've actually been shocking teams when they didn't have good pre-season. And now they can afford to again run. And a poor pass given.
I like the way they are fighting back as a folk. Not giving up at all, but Inter Allies remain resolute at the back.
I talked about the fact that the second half will be a time where clubs would try to checkmate each other. And Inter Allies have done one.
They're just, you know, playing well, just according to strategy. You know, I think they've got variations to their game. At the point in time, they like to use the midfield, and then when they switch, they use Evans Mensah. And that was scary at the back there.
I'm not really liking the play of Roper, but when he lose possession, he's letting go back to win it back for his team, and a lot of pressure sometimes is mounted, and his side. Perhaps he's getting support from Frederick Boateng.
Also, well, maybe Boateng is doing the tracking back, assisting in defending. He stays on top as the man, the arrowhead.
Shuman. Again, a huge clearance. Back to Hartlepool again. And again, lines up. Goes cross and to the goal. Kenichi is being tested this time.
Very much so. He knew it. He talked about it in his pre-match talk that their aim is to come for the 3 points. You know, but Inter Allies, he paid tribute to Inter Allies and their quality. And so he expected them to play this way. The question is, did he have a game plan, you know, to stop Inter Allies?
Well, the midfield is being overstretch. Hard to fuck. Inter Allies also trying to played up there for Mensah and Rupa Park, though Kelahoto doing his job in midfield as well.
And Kumi, you know, tracking back to help his men, you know, mass men in midfield. And this was the goal, the ball from the middle. You know, Buffalo playing a key role. They're sending the ball to the left where Evans Mensah was. Look at the cross. And Boateng, look at how did they allow him to sneak in there?
And Inter Allies in trouble here. Musa with possession. And still holding on tight to the ball.
It doesn't look like he's comfortable on the AstroTurf. You know, looking very clumsy, you know, when he's on the ball. He was supposed to bring some added oof up front for Hartlepool.
Ishman with another ball sent in. Was it a handball? Oh, and Mustafa again.
No, Musa Ibrahim
just can't control the ball.
Yeah, he just can't keep controlling that ball. But I think Inter Allies have been on hibernation the last 5 minutes or so. Hartlepool gradually warming up and trying to test them.
It appears that the Inter Allies team is not in, pretty much in a hurry to maybe get a second goal that will unsettle the hearts of folk. Mensah, and he's already in the offside box there.
You know, quick Evans Mensah, two MVPs. No, under his belt so far. Sam Yeboah has been quiet, Benjamin.
And he's losing possession. The fans are trying to see if at least he can do something. Free kick to Isaac Chum. Again, an over elaboration on his part, but he gets away with it.
You know, because the referee came to his rescue with Sabanlai giving him pressure. You know, trying to showboat, but then that was costly. There was a bit of a push, a slight one. And he was awarded a free kick. You know, the last time we saw Inter Allies and Hartlepool play here in the first, and also that was the first round match. Inter Allies scored first, Rupa Mensah. And then it was equalized. Isaac Odro's free kick. You know, he's not played well, Benjamin. You talked about him. And so they'll bring another fighting, you know, striker. But for me, he's a brawler. Elias Ofusini.
Much was expected of him, and he feels a glitter on the occasion.
For me, if Hartlepool don't know about him, he's a fighter. He'll fight and contest every ball up front. He's got unyielding bravery.
Simon Marte. Trying to find space in Talais.
And they have it also. Nobody closing them down.
Prince Bafu. And well policed there by Osu Bempa. There's a Friedman runs against in Talais here.
Isaac Mensah tracking back to help his men. And this was the incident. Frederick Boateng committing that foul. a bit physical.
Well, Inter Allies have kept 27 clean sheets out of 64 games since 2013, and now they lead by a goal to nil. Can they hold on to this one?
Oh, the last time they played here, they nearly had a shock and had to race into that game to draw 2-2 with Dreams FC.
Surprising once again, looking at how hard the folk have actually been kept to push back majority of time when they have possession, trying to keep it pretty much tight. It's not really the way they expect it. Atinga lousily giving the ball out, and again Italia is doing the same.
That's it. You know, it used to be the trend in the first half, just for a short while before, you know, they turn things around. Not convincing, you know, performance from Vincent Atinga, the former Dwarfs man.
You know, the home fans have been absolutely quiet. They are leading, but you know, they can't rejoice. What is happening?
Well, a few times you can hear some of them trying to get their voices heard. I guess how Italians do win back possession, it's just timing the balls from Hart to Fulk, and they chip the ball wide. Mesa wins it, and they so not so over Hart to Fulk. And Intales again will have to make sure at least their men out there. It's Fatah Mohamed, and he's trying to get support there. And
I think Evan Spencer overdid that one, and he lost, you know, control of the ball. But good pressure from Savanlai. You know, he's an unsung hero for House of Folk. This was the twist and turning coming in from Evans Mensah. And you can see he kept policing him until he lost that ball.
And now Intala is again winning back possession. Liasu drifting it down to Evans Mensah. He's beginning to grow in confidence. And yes,
Ibrahim Alassa making that run. It was a sweet ball threaded down there from Afoto Gokel. Once again, they play straight passing from Ahoto, but then Alassan was, you know, late. You know, could not spot that one early. But nice move there from Inter Allies to open, you know, the House of Folk defense. For me, they've not been that tight, and a flaky one this afternoon.
Now they try to tear the defense apart, and Aket, they've not really been able to be patient with possession. Inter Allies, they try to get 1-2 up there, and Hart of Folk also opening up the gap at the back. We talked about the level of defensive play that is coming in from Hart of Folk, and it appears losing in confidence, and the Italians would have to take advantage of that.
It's becoming scrappy. Was that a handball?
Was it a handball or was it an offside?
And had to overstretch Robin Yan, the Ivorian. You know, covering up there for House of Folk. You know, they are being overstretched. You know, this afternoon, Liasu, the substitute who just came on, you know, testing, you know, the speed of the centre back of House of Folk. And this was Gokel's pass, and that was a handball. And the referee allowed play to continue. Maybe he was playing the advantage. So yes, I think he whistled for, you know, the foul, that handball. And then we understand this, he was booked. Vincent Atinga has been booked.
A free kick. Inter Allies will take it. Oh! Brilliant! That is magnificent! Hart to Fulk, broken. And the man has scored again. He said it. He said he was going to score. What a way to celebrate another victory over House of Hope. And the Fomian fans have been stunned. And this man has gone in back-to-back-to-back games. Look at the free kick. And what was Sulama doing in between the sticks? Ahoto Gokel take that one, and it was swerving. Was it wind assisted? It looks like. And Sulama was beating Flaxley there.
and game over. Trust me, it's game over.
What a game he's having. Gokhela Hoto. He said it, he will do it, and he's done it.
You know, when they lost here by 3-2, David Duncan was in charge with Hearts of Oak. He scored. And last season, the 2-1 win, he scored also. That was at a depth. It was also a powerful delivery. And today, it's 2-0 now, and he scored.
What a real test to Hearts of Oak. And a big test to Kenichi Itohashi. Inter Allies 2, Hearts of Oak 0. First time, Hearts of Oak got down by 2-0 in the season.
They've not played well at all, and Inter Allies deserve to win.
Oh, if the pundits were looking at this, they probably would have wished that the scoreline would have been a different one. But now it's beginning to be an embarrassment to Hearts of Oak. They just can't get the passes going, and they are always being torn apart in their own half. Inter Allies are just sensational.
What a rope check there from Inter Allies. When we thought their season was going to be a down script one, they've been able to revise their notes. And this has been a solid performance. Not impeccable, but nice to watch.
Again, yeah, well organized in defense. They whip up possession so easily.
You know, and they do well also to keep possession. Hearts of Oak must show their true character.
So, just really looking at how the Fabians can garner some bit of energy and hit back at Inter Allies. They never say die until the bones are rotten. They always say, and they always do it. But this time, doesn't look like a Herculean task for them to surmount.
Gradually, Hearts of Oak self-believe.
Well, so they have pulled one here. It is not over yet. Hearts of Oak said it. They never say die until the bones are rotten.
You know, they came in there, Kwame Bar, poor goalkeeping. I don't think he saw it coming. But if you're asking questions about the defending, look at the powerful throw-in from Fatau. It wasn't cleared well, nobody marking. And then, bam, inside the net. And Hearts of Oak will find out Isaac Mensah with that goal. You know, good strike there. You know, by netting, and Bam confused at this point in time.
And now, there's a chase for it now. And the Inter Allies still find themselves in all sorts of trouble.
This is where we're going to see Hearts of Oak true character. Against Inter Allies.
The fans of Hearts of Oak do find they found their voices back.
And then Buffalo seems to have picked up an injury. And that was a best in run there from the former Kotoko man. But before, the deficit was reduced by Isaac Mensah, and this was a free kick. And this is a goal that has halved the deficit here. Headed out, but straight to Mensah, and then shot past the goalkeeper. Maybe he should have organized his men, but Mensah is giving them. And I think he becomes the first player to score in successive week. He scored last week and has scored again. This season, no player has been able to do that.
And Gokhela Hoto is going into history as one of the players who always scores against the Hearts of Oak when he gets the chance.
And that will be their nemesis. Hearts of Oak's nemesis. But then there's still hope alive for Hearts of Oak. They can always bounce back with 20 minutes left on the clock.
So we are greeting counseling for Eric Kumi. And the attacking options of Hearts of Oak reinvigorated. And looking ahead to making sure at least we get to score another goal. And what they'll be looking for perhaps will be a huge win if they have it.
Oh, corner. I think he has to be booked. And the yellow is out.
Well, not much can be said about him since he came on.
And Ibrahim Musa, you know, picks up a yellow card also. You know, it was a late one. Oh. On Evans Mensah. A late tackle. You know, easily break the leg off. You know, this enterprising winger.
What? The 2013 season. Hartlepool manage a 3-2 win here. And again, Inter Allies winning back possession and trying to surge forward again. Mensah on the left. Over elaboration from him. He obviously can hold on to this possession when he has it. Fatah Mohamed. Plenty of breaks on him. The referee contributing to the attacking play of Hartlepool. Is it?
But this time it was negative. This time it was negative because they ended up losing possession.
If we were to choose the best free kicks in the country since the Premier League season started, which one would be your best?
No, we've seen free kicks. No, I just don't want to pick one. Maybe at the end of the season I'll take stock. The first round I'll take stock and then, you know, pick one. So far we've seen brilliant free kicks. You know, some authentic. Delivered a delicious one. Also, Amos Crunchy of Hazakes. Nice free kick. And then Malik Akowes kick.
Eliasu.
Everybody had, you know, quality 5-star rated free kicks.
Talais pushing forward. Simon Marti. And the Boateng. Oh, beautiful. Simon Marti. And deliver. Eliasu just dummy there, but. There was nobody to support him, and Hartlepool back again defending.
Well, they are now back peddling. They've been pushed to the wall, and the recovery will come in from the midfield. Well, Mustafa Isuman and his men are operating.
Season in Talais lost at home to Wafa. So far played 10 home games. He's winning 5, drawing 5. Scoring 12 goals there, Hartlepool. And again, another poor pass there from the man in white. And Magridi will be given a chance together with Musa. And if he gets the ball out, not much can be said about his contribution since he came on.
He's never been able to give a through pass since coming on.
Also, you probably are looking at how Hartlepool will be able to come back into the game and get a goal to be scored. And so they know that they still have plenty of time to show for that.
You know, Frederick Boateng, I think, is complaining of a muscle problem. He had to stretch, you know, to get that one ball in, but then still couldn't, you know, keep it in play. And Boateng scored the opener here. That was a sweet move there from Prince Bafo to Evans Mensah, and this was where he came. And poor marking there from the far side.
Well, when the ball was drifted to the far end, you obviously were looking at Owusu Bempah. He just stood akimbo. He didn't really see the run of Frederick Boateng.
No, he didn't know what time it was.
A bit physical now. Intala is going to fight to run home with the win if it stays this way. But Hartlepool sometimes can live it late.
You know, they have 5 points, and that will take them, you know, very far on the table, with other matches, we understand, being very, very delicately poised. They need a win badly. They've got 5 from 4, and this win will send them to 8. And Hartlepool also will have to win, because if they don't win and Wild Stars are able to win, then they'll be knocked off the summit of the table.
Still plenty of games to play to come back. And they're very good at home. Ilyasu. An injury scare. Was the first Schumann. It's hard to feel confidence in Atinga. Hoping things are back for them.
A nice recovery there from Kingsley Inamdi. You know, Italians have got some nice partnerships there at the back. Last season it was Baba Mensa and Joseph Aidu. This time around, a new setup, Wahaba Kwei. And the man from Nigeria, Kingsley Inamdi.
A bit of erratic play there from Italians. They still have to come back to defend their lines. They were actually in a celebratory mood when Hartlepool had to score.
You know, judging from how Hartlepool scored, you know, what is the consolation goal at this point in time, then the Inter allies, you know, should be careful because they are capable of striking again.
Lovely ball. And Inter allies have a lot of space with another in-swinger in. It's been cleared out desperately by Inter allies, and anytime the balls are sent into their box, you can actually see the speed at which they try to get the balls out, and Hartlepool growing in confidence at the moment.
No, I think they've realized they've taken their foot off the accelerator.
Well, that is when you always talk about Hartlepool and their strength, because they always say that their strength comes back after 70th minute.
This is testing time, and you know, Hebetado said his men or his troops are also qualified. They can play for 90 minutes. If Hartlepool can't withstand 120 minutes, they want to play for 90 minutes, and he's prepared his voice for 90 minutes. This is not a, you know, a tournament where we need extra time. So in 90 minutes, they would like to finish off with a win, and that's what they are doing now, keeping it cool, playing among themselves, not in a rush.
Simo Mati now. Multiple pressing now. And back to goalkeeper Kwame Ba. So much in terms of options.
Hey, there was a Rabona off a pass. Incredible from Evans Mensah.
A lot of spaces. Mensah. And again, another friendly clearance. And it's a foul now. And there you can see, once again, Inter allies in their own half, trying to stop Hartlepool. Isaac Mensah, Fatal Mohamed.
A nice interception there, pushing the ball for it to be cleared.
And now you have Hartlepool again. There's Musa, tries the ball back, and the fans not approving to his performance, and there's nobody there to start the attack there for Inter allies. All of them back in their own half, and Mensah wins possession, looking for space, and he does well to find his man, and still pushing Inter allies. And Mensah again trying to play with his ball and wait for support.
What a showboating there from Evans. I understand why he's won two Man of the Match awards. Lovely play there from Akoto Gokyo, spreading the ball to the right.
Yeah, Prince Bafo contributed to the two goals.
This time around, it's a 4-1 from Bafo. You know, I thought they could have done something better with Hartlepool, you know, after being, you know, played around by Hartlepool for some 2 minutes on a break. Also would punish us, but that wasn't to be.
It was the third time that Sulama has been beating. Samuel Boy wins it for Hartlepool. And Samuel Boy again. And Hartlepool have scored! Guess who scored? It is the man you've been talking about. 2-2.
What a game, what a comeback. I said we're going to test their season here. And they went to sleep and they've got punished. Pent up celebration from Hearts of Oak fans. This is raw character. And Kenichi will applaud his men for racing back into the game. Now, this was Sammy Eboah's efforts. Went past his man, and nobody was picking Ibrahim Musa up. Sammy Eboah did all the work with his experience. There was a slip from Al Hassan. Sent the ball to Musa, and Kwame Bah will be blamed. You just can't be beaten at a near post. Absolutely unacceptable. And Inter allies have now been shocked.
They have been shocked, but I said it. They never say die until the bones are rotting. And they always show it, and they always leave it late.
And that's what they've been able to do.
Two goes up, and it is all square now. The fans can now afford to come out. And Hearts of Oak now cheered up. They are moving. And Inter allies players know that they have actually let themselves down. Poor defending from them. Complete sense setting your play. And you don't do that when you're playing against Hearts of Oak.
Absolutely. You know, they are the leaders. You have to show them respect, even if going up by 2-0. They needed just to remain focused. And Kwame Bah once again, the goalkeeper, I think he didn't expect that ball to come in from Ibrahim Musa. And we've got deafening sound inside the stadium where Hearts of Oak are dominant.
Well, we spoke about Hearts of Oak and their strength. Now to the 70th minute, that is when they come in strong. And each allies just really trying to get the balls out. And so far, all of them have stayed in their own area, not coming in. The way they are pinging the balls around at the Hearts of Oak. Talies are not really coming. It's Bafo going down, and that is seen as a third challenge.
No, that ball will be kicked out of play because it looks like Ibrahim Musa is on the pitch.
An important away point there for the Fabians.
And this was the goal he scored. Nice play there from Sammy Eboah. And picked up this man inside the box neatly. And at the near post, he got beaten. Kwame Bah.
And just 5 minutes left. And Isaac Chun is out. The Shaibu comes in, played against Ejubiasi, who was not in the starting up of Italians, and the fans of Hearts of Oak very excited at least.
You know, we have such an heavy finish here at the Thomas Paul Stadium. Can Hearts of Oak go for the winner? I think they are capable of winning this game. And he's turning out to be a super sub, Ibrahim Musa.
Time for Inter allies to show if indeed they can actually get the win here, but they have themselves to blame. They scored and they kept playing with a ball anytime they have it. We don't seriously, but when they have possession, they were just not in the right frame of mind to work with it.
You know, and this is Inter allies, or I think it's Inter allies game to lose. Going up by 2-0, there's no, you have no business. Because we are not seeing, this is not a vintage House of Hope side. And so you're, after going on, just close the game down. Keep your eyes firmly on House of Hope. But credit to the Phobians also, you know, for that impressive performance. Even though when they never played well, they managed to get in the goals, and that's more important.
Goal came in from Isaac Mensah. He'd say that Hearts of Oak were capable of coming back, and they did. Anytime the ball is drifted to the left hand side, and appears that Simon Mati is closing things out there.
Free kick, no good one there, Tinga. Going in strongly on Fredrik Kwating. And this will test the energy levels of the players. You know, we've seen what's baking sun here in Tema. Difficult condition to play. And by now, most of the players worn out. But then still, you have to remain concentrated for the last minutes.
And a Hearts of Oak put out to defend. Italia is beginning now to show something. Well played out. Samuel Bois, man who assisted in the second goal, he's possessed and commit a foul there.
A good one there from, you know, the ref.
Ratchet shooting will come in from Interlice. Ratchet let themselves down at least. Well, I did say that Interlice have conceded in all home matches played in the month of March since they came into the Premier League in 2013. And here again, they have conceded against Hearts of Oak.
I think we can get a winner in this match.
Yasu to Shane Atenga.
Oh, that's a foul.
Yasu's contributions pretty much minimal. Inusa. Musa has done his job for Hearts of Oak by scoring, and he has his yet to score. The last time both sides played a drawn game was last season at the Accra Sports Stadium. It was a goalless game. Again, Hearts of Oak. Oh, Musa on the left hand side. Trying to drift inside, and he goes around his man, and he scores!
I told you we're going to get a winner, and the super sub has given Hearts of Oak that win at the death. Incredible! This is fabulous from Hearts of Oak.
Fantastic display there from the Phobians. They have done it again, Hearts of Oak, just as they did it in the 2013-2014 season. That was the dummy, that was the brilliant goal. Oh, glorious.
You know, from the outside of his foot, slammed that one in. Look at the control, the step overs. And Kwame Ba once again beating. Oh, I think he lets Inter allies now, but the credit to Ibrahim Musa, the two-goal hero, and this is the match winner.
Herbert Addo surprised, simply surprised. Kenechi is the man at the moment. Italians have no one to blame but themselves.
You know, going up by two goals, you know, I was convinced it was game over. But then what a way to eat humble pie. Hasselhoff deserve the plaudits. They are a team in form.
Again, Italians see how Viliasu. Italians! Oh! Just not lucky.
And Prince Wapu attempting to score. But there was a lovely run there from the left. And Ibrahim Alassane did well to pick him up. But his connection was wide. So close. And Evan Spencer has been substituted. Prince Barry who comes on. But less than a minute left on the clock. Let's get the best here at the Tema Sports Stadium. The first goal from Frederick Kwati. The second one, Ahoto Gokhel. Powerful free kick from the midfielder. And the comeback from House of Hope. The first one, Isaac Mensah. Bomb. The second, substitute Ibrahim Musa. And we had a third goal from this man. Magical performance from the sub. And the fans, and this is the third goal. The match winner.
Six goals in a matter of days. That's a fuck. 3-1 against Bechem United. 3-2 into Allies.
Highest scoring side. Don't forget about the three goals they've conceded. But then the ability to score goals makes them true title contenders for the season. Second away win of the campaign. That is very, very solid and impressive.
The second time, Hartlepool have beaten Inter Allies by the same score margin here at the Tema Stadium.
Good performance. Let's shower the praises on them.
It comes back to the Phobians. It comes back to Kenechi Uchuhashi. It comes back to the fighting spirit of Accra Hartlepool. They never say die until the bones are written. And that is exactly what they have exhibited here. 2 down, 3-2, and they have actually carried the 3 points. And they can afford to smile. They said they were going to do it, and they have done it a second time against Inter Allies here at the Tema Park. Full-time scores, Hartlepool, they definitely aren't sung. Inter Allies 2, Hartlepool 3.
A blockbuster of a game we have had here at the Tema Sports Stadium. A barren first half and 5 goals in the second half. What a game it has been. But joining me here is the man who has been chosen as man of the match. Unfortunately, he is on the vanquished side. Congratulations. This is about the third time you've been nominated as man of the match during the league. How do you feel about this game?
I'm very happy for this week because I've worked very hard. And then it's just a great game for us because if you watch our 5 matches, it has been a couple of tough games and all those stuff. But at the end of the day, this match was not easy for us because they're a tough team and they have won their matches and also we need to just work hard and all this stuff. But unfortunately, we are lucky by we lost in this game. But we need to, our next game, we just need to improve on the way that we do things and all this stuff. So that's it.
Hard luck and I wish you the best in the subsequent games. And a well-spoken warrior, he's fought very well. And even though he's on the vanquished side, he's managed to prove himself good. Congratulations, coach. How were you able to pull the chestnut out of the blazing fire?
I think everything what player did, all the credits. I didn't do anything. Our players did won the game.
I will let you go have your rest and enjoy the game, but congratulations once again. Coach Kenichi speaking to me here, and he must be a very happy man. And what a game it has been, turning it over. Coach, this must be a very disappointing one for you, leading 2-0 and coming to lose it 2-3 in the long run.
Yeah, it's very, very disappointing. Very, very disappointing, because the second half, I told them that this is what these people are coming to do. They come all out within their feet. So keep the ball, keep the ball. Then you get one or two people trying to do their own thing. They lose the ball, they don't fight back. And that was two goals in the lead, and you come and lose 3-2. It's terrible. We need some work to be done. And I think it wasn't too bad. You know, the boys were determined, and we relaxed. So that's how it should be. It's unfortunate, but it was a good game.
Everyone saw it all, and I'm sure that it wasn't a bad performance after all. But I wish you the best in the subsequent games. Coach Abadad was speaking to me here, very disappointed as it has been, and as you can see on his face, but it's been a brilliant game of football here at the Tema Sports Stadium. And if you've enjoyed it, make sure you join us again on our next outing on Ghana Premier League. And from the Tema Sports Stadium, with the entire crew saying bye-bye to you on the World of Champions.